Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, my name is Erica and I make videos all about making and selling candles. If you guys are interested in checking out what my Etsy shop looks like, or if you want to see any of my merch designs, go ahead and check out the first links in the description box below. Also, don't forget to hit the bell notification. I've noticed that not a lot of people have that on, so if you guys hit the little bell icon, it will notify you guys as soon as I upload a video. But in today's video, we are going to be going over all about labels, how to pick the right size for whatever jar or tin you are looking to label. And also I'm gonna go through all of the labels that I use and tell you what size they are, where I get them, and what I use them for. So first things first, I need to make this clear for you guys. There is no right size for whatever jar you are working with. There are so many different sizes that could look good on a jar, and it really just depends on the look that you're going for. So for instance, I have so many people that are using this size jar and they use a very skinny label like this, it's vertical, or they have a bigger, thicker label on here. The size that I use on this jar, it doesn't mean that that's the size that is the perfect size for this jar. And the best way to know on what size you are going to like on a jar or a tin or anything you're using is take one of these. These are like the little flimsy type of measuring tapes, and just go over the jar and measure it. And measure, okay, well, I kind of want my label to look like this and be maybe 2.5 by 3 or whatever the size is gonna be. And then take a piece of paper and cut that out and then put it up against the jar or tin or whatever it is. And that's how you will really be able to tell if you're going to like a label of that size on that vessel. This is something where even if you do like the sizes that I use for my jars, don't think that that's the only size that you guys can use. You can use any sizes. There's a plethora of different sizes online from multiple different websites that you can order labels from, but don't think that you have to do the sizes that I use on the vessels that I do. You guys can play around with it if you want it to be a little bit bigger or a little bit smaller. It's really just up to you and what you prefer. And that being said, I do get all of my labels from online labels. I have pretty much since the beginning of candle making. I really like their label sizes, the different sizes that they have. I like that you're able to order only one sheet if you want to test things out and you don't have to have a minimum of like 100 sheets at a time or whatever. And I also like that they give you an activation code that you're able to use their design software. So if you guys have been watching my channel for a while now, you know that I do use their Maestro Label Designer to design all of my candle labels. So that is a huge plus when it comes to ordering from them, but I really like the quality of their labels too. Moving on to the very first label that I'm gonna be talking about with you guys. This is the most versatile label I'd say that I have. I use it for a few different things, and that is the 2.2 inch by 2.83 inch labels. And I get these in the glossy white for laser printers. And I use these for a few different things. So I use them for my main candle jars of my 9.5 ounce candles. And I do also use them for my wax melts as well. So on the wax melt, it doesn't fit perfectly around it, but it looks pretty good on the clamshell mold. And then another thing that I do use with this is for my thank you stickers. A couple days ago, I actually ran out of my thank you cards and I didn't know what to do. So I thought it would be cute to make little thank you stickers to put on the product while I'm wrapping it up. And I know it's not the same as a handwritten thank you note, but it did save me a lot more time, let me tell you. I do like doing the thank you notes, but if I ever run out of it, I really like this as another option, and it's kind of the perfect size to put onto the products. Also, something else I use those sizes for that I don't have an example with me right now is I actually use them for little messages when it's a gift purchase. So if somebody is purchasing an item from my Etsy shop and they want to write in a little note to the recipient, I will, instead of just printing that out on Etsy on the paper, I'll make kind of a cute little sticker note to put on it. I just think that it's kind of a cuter touch. The next size that we're gonna be talking about is this size right here on my candle tins. So when I was first trying to figure out what size I was gonna like on here, I did what I said to do earlier. So I took a measuring tape, I just put it right across it, and then I was thinking, okay, I think that maybe 3.something by 1.25 inches is gonna work really well. I went onto online labels, found the closest one, and I purchased a few sheets to try it out, and I absolutely love the way it looks on here. here. And these are the 3.75 inch by 1.25 inch labels. And they just look like this. It comes in a sheet of 12. And again, these are the glossy white for laser printers. And then something else that I use these for is actually for the tops of my Tea Light sample pack. Again, it was just the only label size that I had at the time that I thought would look really nice on it. And I think it just kind of adds a nice little elegant touch to the packaging. I really like the way that the label looks on it. But again, for anything that I'm telling you guys don't have to use these sizes. These are just the sizes that I use. But again, it's just what I had on hand when I was putting it together. So that's something else that I use this size for. And then for the top of my 10s, I chose to put a sticker on the side and on the top. So that's what this looks like right here. And this is 2.5 inch circles. And these, again, are in the glossy white for laser printers. And I really like the way that it looks on there. When I was measuring the top out, it seemed like it was about 2.75 inches, I believe. But I thought that getting this size would look really nice on it. And I'm really, really happy with the way that these look on this candle. Speaking of circles, the next size that I use this for a lot of things. I use this for all of my warning labels. So initially when I started making my warning labels, I used 2-inch circles, and somewhere along the line, I switched over to 1.75. I don't really know why. I can't remember. I don't know if it's because I ran out of the 2-inch circles or what, but it's 1.75 inches now, but I use this for all of my custom warning labels. I make custom warning labels for all of my items, my wax melts, my jars, and also my tins. I have to do special warning labels for my tins because on the label, I actually don't list that this is 6 ounces. So legally I have to put the net weight. So I actually put it on the custom warning label to put on the bottom. And again, I actually chose to get these in matte because they are so much cheaper, and it's just a warning label at the bottom of the candle or at the inside of the clamshell mold for the wax melt. So it doesn't need to be shiny and fancy. I used to get the glossy white for the warning label, but just do matte. And the circles keep getting smaller. So these are the 1.25 inch circles. And I use these for my little samples that I give out with all of my orders. I've talked about this in a previous video. So if you guys wanna check out that video and see kind of all about these and all about my samples, I will link that video above so you guys can check it out. But I really wanted to get a square in the 1.25 inch for these, just so it would fit on here. But apparently that's a special size, so you have to order a ton of them. And I just didn't wanna do that. So that's where the circles came in. But this is the size that I use for these. And I will also use these as little thank you stickers when I am packaging everything up, just to kind of close it together instead of using tape. I will use little thank you stickers. And I've forgotten about that the last time that I packaged everything up. I just didn't have these ready. So I just used tape, but we can't all be perfect all the time, right? And the final size label is kind of a weird size. It's 3.75 by 2.438 inches, and these are on matte paper. So I believe on online labels, when you get matte paper, you can use that for both inkjet and laser, I think. But with these are just little brand stickers until I decide to go and get a stamp for everything. I think that you can go onto Etsy and get that done. But for right now, I've just been doing these little stickers, and, these cost me, I believe, 2 cents each, cause I purchased 100 of these. And I will just take them and put them on the sides of packaging when I'm shipping out orders. I actually also use these for my care card stickers as well. So instead of doing an actual card, I just do a candle care sticker. And that way, one, it saves so much more money. And two, the person is gonna throw it away anyways, so might as well save money on it. And it can be cute and decorative, and you can make it look however you want to. So that's something else that I do with it. Let me real fast tell you guys about the printer that I use, because I love it so much. It has been such an upgrade from the inkjet printer that I bought at Target years ago. I think that printer was maybe $40, $50. It worked really well for the time, but it definitely started having a lot more issues, mainly with alignment, which I know you guys understand alignment issues, so I'm right there with you. So when I switched over to this printer, I was really interested to see how much I would like it with the quality and everything. And this printer is the HP LaserJet Pro MFP M479FDW. And of course, I will have that linked in the description box below if you guys want to check it out. But this is just kind of like a fancy laser printer and it prints in color. The print quality is really, really nice. In the very beginning, it actually was not that nice. And I was able to adjust some printer settings to be able to actually make the quality a lot better. I think I switched it to glossy brochure paper and I got that tip from Jessica from Hawthorne Company. So shout out to you, Jessica, because I don't know if I would have been able to figure that out. I probably would have just been like, this printer is terrible, but no, it's really, really good. And switching the settings did make it print a little bit slower, but not too slow and not as slow as my inkjet printer, because inkjet printer just, it takes so much longer. And also I like how saturated everything is on my labels without being subjected to smearing. So on my inkjet printer, I did have a little bit of smearing on my labels if I tried to saturate it too much. So either there would be lines in between the writing on my inkjet printer, but it wouldn't smear, or if I wanted it to be completely saturated, it would smear. So I don't have an issue with this printer, thankfully. And in terms of alignment, I think that has to do a lot with like your printer settings to make sure you're doing everything right. But so far, I haven't had too many issues. There have been a few times where it's been a little off alignment and it's been kind of weird, but I'll just turn it off, turn it back on, make sure that I'm putting the paper in the tray properly, because I feel like maybe it's been my fault I haven't pushed it all the way back or there's been something weird with it. But for the most part, it hasn't had too many alignment issues. Everything's been pretty good. And I know this is not candle label related, but it is the coolest thing to be able to scan something and have it come up immediately on your phone and then also print something directly from your phone. It's the coolest thing ever and I love it so much. I've never had such a fancy printer before, so I'm very thankful for my candle business to allow me to have such a fancy printer. I feel very special. But anyways, guys, I really hope that you did enjoy today's video all on labels, my printer, everything that I use. And I really hope the tip on using a measuring tape and trying to cut and paste something on a piece of paper to tell what kind of label you want for whatever vessel you're working with helped you guys. I really do think that there are so many different labels that will look nice on all different kinds of vessels. So just kind of play around with it and see what you like best. If you guys liked today's video, make sure to leave it a thumbs up as well as subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. And don't forget to follow me over on Instagram at MemoryBoxCandleCo. And I will see you guys in the next video. Bye, guys.